We're spotlighting the trades and the work of an instructor building relationships and bridges literally with his students. Lauren Jiggins has more in our April Teacher of the Month.
It's in this space in Melrose Park that the skills are learned to create the metal joints that will help construct everything from bridges to skyscrapers, pipelines, and airplanes. And it's a source of great pride for Lincoln Tech instructor Joel Smith.
It's my job to push them to be that welder they know they can be, because they would settle. They're looking for that grade. I can go to my next task.
Is this two passes or one?
One.
All right, we gotta start cleaning it. You watch your heat.
Cool, but I know you can do better. Let's go. And that's where the firmness comes in, and they genuinely know it comes from a good place. They do.
And his students do know this. Eddie Amaya nominated Joel. In September, he came through the doors of Lincoln Tech intimidated with little knowledge about welding, but he found a father-like figure in Joel.
He would just push me. He would just, I'll do a bad weld. He would say, just do it again, Eddie. And then I was like, oh. I think one time I started crying. But I know it was coming from a good place, a good heart.
I think you're adding a little too much filler. That's why you're getting these crown little welds.
And that's what we heard from the 30 men and women he teaches every day. A teacher who will give you honest and firm feedback, but with a big heart.
One time I was like really down. And I was like, yo, Joe, I gotta take a breather. And there's like a door back there. And he like, I was like, he put his hand right here. And he goes, he's like, Eddie, you gave me this much. And I promise you, I'll get you there.
We're gonna work on you just being comfortable. That's half the battle with TIG.
Joel's father was in the trades, and he got interested in welding after talking to an instructor here.
And I remember I was managing a doggy daycare facility, and I went to him. I was like, you're making $14 an hour, I'm making $9. He's like, yeah, I just went to school, learned to weld, and now I got a welding job. So I've honestly give a lot of my credit to another fellow instructor here.
And as soon as he got the job, he knew he also wanted to teach.
Not only am I teaching the students how to weld, financial literacy, how to navigate life, just being a mentor. A lot of these students don't fully have somebody they can come to in competence and talk to and give them honest feedback. So that's really what's kept me around, is just impacting these students, being a mentor.
He's been teaching for 5 years, taking his students on field trips to make sure they understand the real life importance of their work.
You don't want the bridge to fail because one day you had an off day welding. So I think us taking these field trips, showing them firsthand an industry they've never dabbled in.
We would dissect this weld, cut a 1-inch strip out of it.
And he wants his classroom to be the place where students feel comfortable learning from their mistakes and realize they can keep growing.
Get back up and do it again. Get back up. Every welder has busted or failed a weld test. And if they say they haven't, they are lying.
There you go.
Many of these students will find work welding or even inspecting welds. After 5 years and hundreds of students, Joel knows his students are ready.
I don't care what people say about trades people or this generation. You guys work hard. Keep it up. Break that barrier down. I'm sick of trades people saying this generation doesn't want to work. You guys show up every day, prove them wrong. Continue doing it.
Howard Ankin of Ankin Law presented Joel with a $1,000 check.
I'm attorney Howard Ankin. On behalf of Ankin Law, I'm proud to present to you, Teacher Smith, the WGN Teacher of the Month Award.
Traditionally, the Teacher of the Month check is addressed to the school, but at Joel's request, the money is going to be donated to a charity close to his heart, Guide Dogs of America.
We can train an animal to help visually impaired individuals. Like, come on. There's no better feeling than that.
It's a no-brainer, really.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Now when you roll, start pivoting your wrist a little more. There you go.
Reporting. If you'd like to nominate an outstanding educator, you can go to our website, WGNTV.com.